Now, before we start, I'd encourage you to draw a diagram, something along these kind of lines, where we've got our particle P and Q, P of mass M, Q of mass 3M. And we're told that before the collision, P is moving towards Q with a speed of 4U, and Q is at rest, so I've just marked that in as zero speed there. And then after the collision, we're told that P reverses direction. So I've called that final velocity VP and changed obviously the direction. We don't know the speed of Q after the collision, so I've called it VQ, and it's got to go to the right because obviously it was stationary here, and if it gets hit by P, it's got to move to the right. So if that coefficient of restitution is E, we've got to show that E is greater than a third. So to do a problem like this, we're going to look at the conservation of linear momentum and also Newton's law of restitution. Form a couple of equations with VP and VQ in, solve them simultaneously, and see then if we can find some inequality relating E. Okay, well, let's just start then by looking at the conservation of momentum. So I'll just put here by the conservation of momentum. Put cons of momentum, okay, just for short. Just gives the examiner some idea, hopefully, what we're attempting to do. And in the usual way, we're dealing with vector quantities here, so set up a positive sense. It doesn't matter which direction you have, but just stick to it, okay? So I'm taking to the right as positive. So in the usual way then, we've got momentum before impact equals the total momentum after impact. And the momentum before impact is going to be the momentum of P, which is the mass M times the velocity 4U. And then we've got plus the momentum of Q. Well, that's going to be simply zero because it's the mass 3m times the velocity zero. And that equals now the final momentum. So the momentum of P now is going to be m multiplied by negative vp, okay, because it's going in the opposite sense. And then we've got the momentum of Q, which is going to be 3m times vq, 3m vq. Now, M is in every term, so we could cancel that out, simplify the problem. And what else can we do? Well, this is going to be zero, isn't it? So we've got, therefore, 4U equals minus VP plus 3VQ. So minus VP plus 3VQ. Now at this stage, I'd want to make VQ the subject. I'm going to work off VP in the next part. So let's make VQ the subject. So if I was to add VP to both sides, we've got 3VQ equals 4U plus VP, and then divide by 3, so we therefore have that VQ equals 4U plus VP, all divided by 3. Okay, we'll put that one on hold for the moment. We'll call that equation 1. Now, what we're going to need to do next is to look at Newton's law of restitution. So we'll just put that up here. Newton's law of restitution. So what is this? Well, essentially, we've got the coefficient of restitution E compares the relative speed of separation with the relative speed of approach. Now, the relative speed of separation, because they're going in opposite directions, is going to obviously be increased. It will be VP plus VQ. So we'll put VP plus VQ. And then we compare this to the relative speed of approach. So that relative speed of approach is going to be just simply 4U because Q was originally stationary. So that will be compared to 4U. Now if we multiply both sides by, say, 4U and make VP the subject, then we'd have that VP would equal 4UE, and then we'd subtract the VQ, minus VQ. Now we know what VQ is from 1 here, so we can substitute 1 into this equation. So if we do that, we've got VP equals 4UE minus VP, so that's going to be 4U plus VP over 3. Okay, let's just put here from 1, okay, from 1. Now I'm going to get rid of this fraction here. What I want to do is rearrange this to make VP the subject. So we'll multiply both sides throughout by this 3, okay? So if we do that, we've got 3VP, so therefore 3VP equals 12UE, 12UE. Got to be careful here because we've got this minus operating over these two terms, so we're going to have minus 4U minus though the VP. So if I add VP to both sides, we've got 4VP equals, and for the right hand side here, I could pull out say 4U as a common factor, so we've got 4U and then that would be 3E minus 1. And if I divide both sides by the 4, we therefore have that VP equals U multiplied by 3E minus 1. Now this is the good bit in this question, where we start to build this inequality, where we get it from. And that is because we've taken VP as going to the left here. So we've kept it as a positive value. And because of that, we can say that therefore since VP remains positive, because if it was negative, it would be back in the other direction now. But since VP is positive, it means that U times 3E minus 1 must be greater than 0. So therefore U bracket 3E minus 1 must be greater than 0. Well, we know that U is greater than 0, okay? It's a speed. And that means that if we've got a positive quantity here, we must multiply it by a positive quantity here. So therefore 3E minus 1 must be greater than 0. And if you rearrange this for E by adding 1 to both sides and dividing by 3, it follows that E must be greater than 1/3, the value that we had to prove. Okay, so there you go. There's the answer to question 2 then.